India is an agricultural country. Two-thirds of its population is involved in agricultural activities. Agriculture is a primary activity. It produces most of the food that we consume. It also produces raw material for various industries besides food grains. In this chapter, we will study the following concepts: characteristics of Indian agriculture, institutional and technological reforms.
Agriculture farming is an agricultural activity and generally includes cultivation of crops and raising of livestock for livelihood. There are many types of agricultural crops as well as livestock. The choice of crop or livestock depends on a number of factors. Chief among these are agricultural development, raw materials for industries, and food security for the country. Characteristics of Indian agriculture. In India, land has been cultivated for the past 3,000 to 5,000 years, depending on the area. India is regarded as a unique country from not only a cultural but an agricultural point of view also. This is due to its fertile soils, wide climatic variations, variety of landforms, and ample sunshine that a wide variety of crops grow here. The main features of Indian agriculture include the following: high proportion of arable land. India has high proportion of arable land, about 43%, the highest in the world. Intensity of cropping. In India, on account of tropical climate and longer hours of daylight, multiple cropping patterns prevail, making high intensity of cropping a phenomena of Indian agriculture. Variation in net sown area. The proportion of net sown area to geographical area varies greatly from state to state. It is about 84.2% in Punjab and only 3.4% in Arunachal Pradesh. It has an inverse relationship with forest cover. Irrigation. Only about one-third of cropped area is actually irrigated. Small farmers in many parts still follow primitive traditional agricultural practices. Landholding pattern. Farmers in India own small plots of land and grow crops mostly for family consumption. More than one-third of the land holdings are small. Dependence on monsoon rains. There is high dependence on monsoon rains during 4-month period, from June to September. Rest of the months are generally dry. Preponderance of food crops. Indian farmers mostly depend on food crops to meet their food requirements rather than commercial crops, to meet their capital and cash needs. Inadequate means of transport, particularly in rural areas. The use of fertilizers, pesticides, and high-yielding varieties of seeds are increasing as a result of awareness created by Green Revolution. Types of farming. Under the influence of above factors, different types of farming or agriculture practiced in India are the following. Shift agriculture. It is a form of primitive agriculture. It is known by different names in different parts of the world, like, for example, jhooming in Northeast India, milpa in Central America, roca in Brazil, masol in Congo Basin, canoco in Venezuela. Under shifting agriculture, a small plot of land is cleared by felling trees and often burning bushes and grasses by what is known as slash and burn method. Intensive agriculture. Higher light intensity, humid and warm climate, higher inputs of labor and capital as well as use of fertilizers make possible raising of two or more crops a year on the same plot of land. This not only helps to increase the crop yield, but also multiple cropping pattern. The Government of India initiated Intensive Agricultural Area Program, IAAP, in 1960s. Primitive subsistence agriculture. In subsistence agriculture, the farmers grow just enough crops for their own consumption and their family. They may also practice intensive agriculture. In places where irrigation is available, farmers now also cultivate cash crops like oilseeds, sugarcane, cotton and jute. In this way, subsistence agriculture has given way to commercial agriculture. Commercial agriculture. In commercial agriculture, crops are raised for the market. In India, commercial agriculture has also taken roots after Green Revolution in 1970s. Many parts of Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh now specialize in commercial farming of basmati rice, though the size of farms is small and mechanization is not as extensive as in Europe and the USA. Plantation agriculture. It is also called tree or bush farming. Plantation crops like tea and coffee are grown in tropical parts of India and Sri Lanka, and rubber plantation in Malaysia are examples of plantation agriculture. It is essentially a type of commercial agriculture as crops are grown for sale in the market. Plantations are very large. Most operations are carried out manually. Only processing is done by machines. Women are generally employed in picking tea leaves and coffee berries, which yield coffee beans. Plantation agriculture. In mixed farming, emphasis is on both crop producing and raising of livestock. Mixed crop cultivation is also carried out in India. Dairy farming. Dairy farming involves cattle rearing, especially milch cows, for milk and milk products. India has achieved some significant breakthrough in cooperative dairy farming, with Gujarat taking the lead, followed by Punjab and Madhya Pradesh. Sedentary farming. As opposed to primitive shifting agriculture, today almost all agriculture can be described as sedentary agriculture or settled agriculture. The methods of crop rotation, fallow land, mixed farming, livestock farming, mechanization, intensive and extensive agriculture, terrace farming are all features of sedentary agriculture. Today, most of world's food supply depends on sedentary agriculture. Truck farming. Trucks are commercial vehicles used for carrying goods from manufacturing centers to markets in urban areas. This type of farming is so called because vegetables, fruits and flowers are perishable commodities and transported in trucks. The vegetable farms in India cater to local markets, unlike in Europe and the USA, where these perishable commodities are carried to vast distances across states and even countries using air transport. Cropping pattern. Crops grown in a region during particular seasons constitute the cropping pattern. In India, food crops have been cultivated for at least 5,000 years. While earlier, there were only two cropping seasons, Rabi and Kharif, use of new quick-growing hybrid seeds and irrigation have made third cropping season, known as ZAID, possible. It is called monsoon crop season. It begins with the onset of monsoon in June and continues until September, when the crops are harvested. Major crops of this season are rice, maize, cotton, oilseeds, etc. Rabi. It is known as winter cropping season and starts in October-November, and the crops are harvested in the beginning of summer. Major crops of this season include wheat, peas, gram, and oilseeds such as linseed, rapeseed, and mustard. These crops are grown mainly in Punjab, Haryana, Jammu and Kashmir, and Himachal Pradesh. Zaid. It is known as summer cropping season and is possible in areas of irrigation works. In dry land farming, emphasis is on conservation of moisture, and dry crops such as jowar, bajra, and pulses are grown. Only one crop is grown during a year. Wetland farming is practiced in high rainfall and irrigated areas. The important crops include rice, sugarcane, and vegetables. Major crops. The two staple food crops of the world are rice and wheat, which together feed more than 75% of world's people. The vast majority of the poor in developing countries cannot afford rice and wheat. Only a small percentage of rich people use other food products like meat, milk, and milk products, not as supplements but as complete balanced diet. Cereals. Rice is the staple food crop of India. It is a tropical plant that thrives well in hot and humid climate. It is essentially a kharif crop in India. It requires mean monthly temperature of 25 degrees Celsius and a rainfall of 100 centimeters and above. It is cultivated in the eastern coastal plain, including West Bengal,
Odisha,
Andhra Pradesh, and Tamil Nadu, western coastal strip, northern plains of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, and Bihar, with the help of irrigation, northeast hilly states of India, Tarai region, and in the deltas on the east coast. Cereals. Wheat is the master grain of India and second most important food crop after rice. It is the staple food of people in northern India. Wheat is the oldest crop and has been grown for at least 4,000 years. Geographical conditions for growth. Wheat needs a cool, wet climate, 10 degree to 15 degree Celsius temperature during growing season, and a warm, dry climate, 20 degree to 25 degree temperature during harvesting season. It requires a rainfall of 75 cm to 100 cm. It is a Rabi crop. Areas of cultivation. Wheat is grown in northwestern plains, particularly in Punjab, Haryana, and western Uttar Pradesh. It grows well in loamy soils of these areas. Wheat is also grown in Madhya Pradesh, some parts of Bihar, Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Maharashtra. Production and yield. India surged ahead of USA in world wheat production and is the second largest producer after China. India has become self-sufficient in wheat production due to Green Revolution. Millet. The term millet includes a number of coarser or inferior grains like jowar and bajra. These are grown in drier parts of the country. They are also known as dry crops. India is the largest producer of millets in the world, with a share of about 33% in total world production. Maize. Maize is a cereal crop and a coarse grain in northern plains and hilly tracts. It is used both as a food and a fodder crop. It provides starch and glucose for industrial purposes. In recent years, maize has found wide acceptability with many affluent families. Maize is grown mostly as a kharif crop. It needs high temperature, 21 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. Frost is fatal for it. It grows under a moderate rainfall of 75 cm to 100 cm. It is grown practically in all parts of India, Uttar Pradesh being its leading producer. It is an important crop in the wheat belt of northern India, Punjab, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Karnataka, and Gujarat are other maize-producing states. Pulses. Pulses are an important source of protein in our vegetarian diet. These plants fix atmospheric nitrogen in the soils and help to restore the fertility of soils. Most pulses are rotation crops. Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, and Haryana are the main producers of gram. The total production is 6 million tons. Red gram or tur is another important millet whose total production is 2 million tons. Oil seeds. Oil seeds are an important group of commercial crops. Oil is an essential fat content in human diet. Oil cake serves as cattle feed. Non-edible oils are used for making medicines, varnishes, perfumes, candles, soaps, and lubricants. Production. India is the largest producer of oil seeds in the world. It has the largest area under oilseed cultivation in the world, covering about 12% cultivated area of India. Groundnuts. India is the largest producer of groundnuts in the world. It needs high temperature, 25 degrees Celsius, and moderate rainfall, 75 centimeters. It grows well in dry, light, sandy soils under irrigation. It is a kharif crop. Most of the groundnut is grown in peninsular India. The main producers are Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, and Punjab. Castor seed. Castor seed oil is used for medicines and lubricating. The crop is grown in warm, dry climate as a kharif crop. It grows well on red sandy soils. The main producers are Gujarat, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, and Rajasthan. Sesamum. It is also eaten in fried and sweetened form. It needs high temperature, 21 degrees Celsius, and moderate rainfall. It needs well-drained sandy loams. Heavy rainfall and frost is harmful. Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, and Gujarat are leading producers of sesamum. Rapeseed and mustard. These are important edible oils. These are used for preparing pickles, curries, and vegetables. It is also an important cattle feed. These are winter rabi crops. Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, and Punjab are their main producers. Sugarcane. Sugarcane is also known as a cash crop because it is grown by farmers for selling it in the market. India is considered to be the original home of sugarcane. Sugarcane is a plant of hot, wet, tropical region. It needs high temperature, 21 degree to 27 degree, and high rainfall, 75 centimeter to 150 centimeter. It grows best on well-drained alluvial soil. Area and production.
Uttar Pradesh,
Punjab, Haryana, and Bihar are other states producing sugarcane in northern India. Southern India, with its hot wet climate, has favorable conditions also. As a result, higher yield is obtained there.
Odisha,
Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, and Maharashtra, as well as the deltas of Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, and Kaveri, are other main producers of sugarcane. Tea. Tea and coffee are also known as beverage or plantation crops. Assam is the native place of tea. Tea is often called the queen of beverages. It is a plantation crop introduced by the British in 1823. At present, it provides direct employment to 5 lakh persons. Geographical conditions for growth. Tea is a plant of both tropical and temperate areas. It requires uniformly high temperature, 20 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius, throughout the year. Frost is harmful for tea leaves. Area and production. Tea is a commercial crop in India. India is the largest producer and exporter of tea, 32% in the world. Areas of cultivation. Northern India produces more tea than southern India. Tea is grown in an area of 4.21 lakh hectares. Other areas of tea production are Ranchi Plateau in Jharkhand, Palampur in Himachal Pradesh, Kumaon and Garhwal Hills of Uttarakhand, and Tripura. Coffee. Coffee is a plantation as well as a beverage crop. It is used as a powder that is obtained after grinding its berries or coffee beans for making brewed coffee. Geographical conditions for growth. Coffee is a plant of tropical and subtropical regions. It requires uniformly high temperatures between 15 degrees Celsius and 28 degrees Celsius throughout the year. It needs an annual rainfall between 150 to 200 centimeters. Area and production. Coffee was introduced into the coffee growing zones in India by a Muslim fakir named Baba Budan. A plantation was started in 1830 in Chikmagalur district of Karnataka. India produces about 2 lakh tons of coffee on an area of 2 lakh hectares. Areas of cultivation. Karnataka is the largest coffee producing state of India. Arcot, Tirunelveli, Madurai and Coimbatore districts of Tamil Nadu grow coffee. In Kerala, cardamom hills covering the districts of Palghat and Thiruvananthapuram grow coffee. Horticulture crops. The cultivation of trees and bushes in a garden, orchard and nursery is called horticulture. Hort is a Latin word meaning garden, to which the term culture has been suffixed. Generally, the cultivation of flowers, fruits, ornamental plants and many vegetables are termed as horticultural crops. Spices include cinnamon, ginger, cardamom, onion, garlic, clove, chili and turmeric. India is the second largest producer of pepper and cardamom after Indonesia. Kerala, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu are leading states of spice production. Fruits. Fruit cultivation is known as horticulture. India is gradually reaching ahead to take over the position of Brazil in fruit and vegetable production. India's three most important fruit crops are mango, banana, and grapes. Vegetables. With many innovative schemes launched in recent years, India has emerged as a leading vegetable producer of the world. Earlier, it was known as truck farming, catering to urban markets. Vegetables and flowers have now also entered the international trade. India accounts for about 13% of world vegetable production and tops in the production of peas and cauliflower. India stands second in world production of onion, cabbage, tomatoes, brinjal, and comes fourth in potato production. Rubber. Rubber is an industrial raw material. It is obtained from the latex hevea type wild trees of equatorial forests. It has long been used for erasing pencil marks. Area and production. Rubber plantation was introduced in 1902 in Kerala. Rubber is mainly grown in southern states of Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Fiber crops. Cotton. Cotton has been called the universal fiber and is the leading fiber crop of India. It is the most important of all the fibers. Geographical conditions for growth. Cotton needs uniformly high summer temperatures between 22 degrees Celsius to 32 degrees Celsius. It requires a warm climate, 210 frost-free days, and bright sunshine.
Jute. Jute is known as the golden fiber. It thrives on well-drained fertile soils in the floodplains where soils are renewed every year. During the time of growth, high temperature is required. The major jute-producing states are Assam, West Bengal, Bihar,
Odisha,
and Meghalaya. Main products of jute are ropes, mats, gunny bags, yarn, carpets, and other artifacts. Due to its high cost, synthetic fibers and packing materials, particularly the nylon, is replacing it fast in the market.